Let's first understand the rules for writing good Gherkin. These rules can provide a nice framework foundation for understanding the right ways to write it, so it becomes a little easier to understand some of the bad practices. The first rule is the golden rule. And as the name would suggest, it's very similar to the traditional golden rule in that we would hope that the way that we write our scenarios, our feature files, is much the same way we would expect others to write them for us. In essence, we want to make sure that everyone on the team can intuitively understand what the content of our scenarios is. One of the main objectives of behavior-driven development is for us to bridge the communication gap between business and technology. So what we want to achieve is for everyone to collaborate and to be fully engaged in the process, and that should lead to scenarios that everyone can understand. The next rule is the cardinal rule. And this is really probably the most important rule. At its most basic, it states that one scenario should cover exactly one single independent behavior. We simply don't want to have scenarios that have a whole bunch of behaviors piled into them. While it might seem efficient at some level to have these really long end-to-end scenarios with all those behaviors, it really confuses things. The lack of concision also leads to a lot of lack of clarity, confusion. It becomes much more difficult to maintain. So keep it simple and make sure that there's one single independent behavior in each of your scenarios. No more. And then the final rule is the unique example rule. Essentially, you want to hit all of your boundary conditions. Once you've hit your boundary conditions, you don't need to go above and beyond those boundary conditions. Beyond those, you're doing a lot of unnecessary testing. We want to make sure that we only hit the most important things, only test the most important things, avoid test duplication. Don't waste a lot of time trying to test all the things. It's just unnecessary. If you follow these three rules for writing good Gherkin, you'll largely be able to avoid a lot of the anti-patterns.